Tucker Carlson gets pranked by misinformation weirdos. Kate Middleton gets Brazilian booty lift by lizard people. Ha ha, that's right, friends. We're going to talk about Tucker Carlson because I guess he got pranked. Like, there's no true confirmation, but the YouTubers who did it got one over on him because I guess they released it first. Very weird, bizarre story to add to an even more bizarre story that we wouldn't normally follow except for the fact that it showed up on YouTube and X. And it's kind of funny. I'll give it a rating by the end. But I am the man you may know as Z from Our Reviews Will Kill You. And I am here to talk to you about this story. Gonna bring it on up. In case you weren't following the news, which I don't blame you if you're not. Well, first we'll talk about the news and we'll get some context on it. So Tucker Carlson duped by YouTubers into interviewing fake Kate Middleton whistleblower. Now, we'll know this is real if they both show up. If they accident themselves, you know, join a certain club just like another whistleblower. But jokes aside, let's take a look at the fact. Kate Middleton's been missing since like January and she apparently is alive. But let's take a look. I don't really understand. I don't look at Photoshop close enough or even photo editing to know or care. This is the video or the picture that's in question. Her with her three children. And you know how I know it's fake? Because they all have monster teeth. I don't know if you can see this, but their teeth look very scary when her teeth look perfect. So she bothered to photo edit her teeth perfect, but didn't Photoshop her children's teeth. I don't believe it. I don't actually know what's going on here, but people tell me in the news that she might not be real. Something about misaligned tiles, and there's like a whole thing. People are freaking out. They wouldn't even... She posted this, or somebody released this picture. Who even says it was her? And the Associated Press and other services refused to show the picture because it might be digitally altered. Uh-huh. So there's something about missing hands and fingers and hair and janky knees. I don't know. I don't know what I'm even looking at. It's not like you're looking at one of those, a Jenner picture or who's the queen of bad Photoshop. I'm sure there's a bunch of them. Yeezy's former wife. And Kim Kardashian, she does bad photoshopping or bad editing, but I don't know. Either way, they're saying the story goes is she was like she'd been abducted by aliens. She's not real. The one thing I'll say, there was a new recent video of her out. Clearly, this is a body double. That is not the Princess of Wales. That does not look like her. That looks like him. And I am by no means an expert. That looks like a totally different human being, if I were to say so myself. That's supposed to be her. I don't know. Supposedly there's better pictures. Who knows? Who cares? But the funny part is, and I kind of agree with Tucker, where he's like, so he gets these guys who prank him. They're a notorious YouTube team. Called Josh and Archie, very British name of them, Archie, huh? And they claimed to be whistleblowers, that they were doctoring images or some nonsense for this Mother's Day image. So they did an interview with Carlson, and then they filmed a bunch of it. So it is funny because they introduce the guest. They say, we've done our best to verify that your identity is what you say it is. You're not a fake Navalny or doing a prank or something. And he says, I was fired for negligence because the editing that I did was found. The editing job was almost too big to do. But let's just catch a little bit. We'll skip around in this video. We don't have to watch the whole thing.
That was great, and it was really interesting too. I did not expect to be as interested in it as I was.
Is this Kate Middleton?
So, you know, I get it. Tucker's like, yeah, like I did this video because you claim to be who you say you are. And he's like, I don't know that I really care, but I guess it was interesting what you did.
Kate Middleton, Princess of Wales, has taken a number of weeks off of royal duties. And it's caused some to believe that the public are not being told something. Conspiracies have ranged from her being far more unwell than we are being told.
Maybe if she's the Princess of Wales, maybe she went to go live with whales. I don't know. But then
people have replied.
Saying what?
They're calling today at 6 p.m.
Okay, yeah. Right, fine. I'll await that call.
As I was abroad, Archie waited for Tucker's people to ring.
So okay, then they get, they
so
get
yeah,
the call.
I was just saw the email that you had sent. So if you could just kind of explain story.
And... I was working for the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge as they were then, and the Princess and Princess of Wales. We all work out of KP, Kensington Palace. And I was asked.
We all work out of KP. I guess if you say anything in a British accent, you can get away with it.
To edit a photograph that was going to be sent out to all mainstream media. The media outlets that we release our images to, so AP and those kind of image distribution companies.
Yeah. So anyway, they go on, they do their thing, and...
...taken on in mid-May as their director, as their producer of digital content. And my job was to film them when they're out and about on public engagements.
And you did that until when?
Yesterday morning.
Having established who Archie was and what he did, Tucker asked him to explain his story.
So I was asked to...
I think this is AI, Tucker. I don't even know if this is real. I believe nothing anymore. I think everything is fake. This is fake news. Tucker has not even responded to this.
As I was, and that was because you wrote such a great story.
So they either got him or it's fake, or I don't even know what's going on. I'll give them a 10 out of 10 for... ingenuity, picking up on a weird story, being like, I'm the whistleblower that photoshopped this picture. Okay, buddy. And the interesting part is they didn't allow Tucker to release. Well, it's not that they didn't allow him to release the video, is that they preempted Tucker and released the video early, their video early, saying we pranked them because they didn't want disinformation to be shown to Carlson's 12.6 million followers. What disinformation? You didn't Photoshop it? Whoop-de-woo. Like, somebody did. It's the greatest Photoshop heard around the world. Digitally altered photos. So it was kind of funny. And they claim that nobody in the British mainstream media would touch it. But they did leave some clues in their tracks, which I thought was amusing, because not everybody picked up on this. And who knows how much of it is true. But these are just, a couple of Yahoos having some funs with people. But they said, and they gave them a clause in their contract. They gave, like, copies of contracts, like fake employment contracts and falsified documents for them to look at. And I guess their team, Tucker's team, like, he probably doesn't, like, how long is the interview? Like, 10 minutes or 15 minutes? They probably have, they didn't have time to fact check it. They're just like, here, let's film this with these guys. And if it looks good, we can make a piece out of it. We'll release it if we can fact check anything, right? So in their clause, he claims that he put in that the royals reserve the right to amputate one limb of their choosing should manners fail his probationary period. So I think this is all very bizarre, but fun. So 10 out of 10 for tricking people. If it's not AI, if it's AI, then I feel like I would give them. If it's AI Tucker, then it's still 10 out of 10. Kudos to you, good sirs, as you pulled one over. I don't even know what to make of this, but I would suspect that Tucker probably would have figured this one out and was just filming it and bagging it. And, good on these guys for not letting him put it out, even though they keep it going. It's fun. He would have figured it out regardless, I'm sure. But anyway, what do you guys think? Do you think he would have figured it out? Do you think this is funny? I think it's pretty amusing because everybody's freaking out about this princess chick. And like I said, my theory is she's living with the whales now. not living with the fishes, specifically whales. Anyway, if you like what you hear here, we do have a podcast you could check out on iTunes. You can also catch us on 7:30 p.m. Friday night, 7:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Come hang out with us. We live stream here on YouTube. We're also on Rumble. Come hang out. You could join the channel. We have some benefits, some giveaways and things that you can participate in exclusively to our members. But in the meantime, I'm on to the next one.